The end is finally near for NASA's Kepler spacecraft, with the fuel tanks expected to run dry in August of 2018. But before the undisputed champ of exoplanet hide-and-seek retires and drifts off quietly into space, we thought we'd look back on the highlights of the 9-year mission. Kepler was launched in March of 2009 with one mission: to search for planets outside our solar system. Rather than orbiting the Earth like the Hubble Space Telescope, Kepler was placed in what's called an Earth-trailing orbit around the Sun. It's a little wider and a little slower than ours. So over time, it would slowly drift away from Earth until it was millions of miles out. That means that we can't send astronauts to repair Kepler like we've done with Hubble. But so long as nothing goes wrong, this orbit has a lot of advantages. It keeps the Earth from photobombing the shot, for example. And since it's out of Earth's atmosphere, the stars won't twinkle. The orbit also eliminates external torques caused by atmospheric friction or Earth's magnetic field, meaning the craft can stably point at one spot in the sky for a long time. The largest external torque on Kepler actually comes from solar pressure, but four small wheels that act as gyroscopes stabilize the craft and counteract it. Aside from a disposable cover, these are the only moving parts on the whole spacecraft, reducing the chances that something could break when it's so far away. Once in orbit, Kepler continuously stared at the same patch of sky in the Cygnus-Lyra region, watching 150,000 main sequence stars for the tiniest drop in light levels that indicate a transiting planet. The only time it broke its gaze was once a month when it turned to transmit data back to Earth. It was basically the most formidable staring contest opponent humanity could ever create. Kepler identified over 2,300 confirmed extrasolar planets, 30 of which are less than twice Earth's size and in the habitable zone, making them candidates to support extraterrestrial life. Kepler chugged along just fine for a while, even though one of its reaction wheels broke in July of 2012. Then in 2013, only 4 years after launch, disaster struck. Remember all the foreshadowing I did about the wheels being the only moving parts of the craft and it's being too far away for it to be repaired? Well, a second wheel broke, and two functional wheels was just not enough to keep the camera steady on the spacecraft. Without the ability to stabilize itself, Kepler couldn't continue its original mission, and it looked like the end, until someone had a brainwave. Why not use the solar pressure to act like a third stabilizing wheel? Kepler wouldn't be able to look where it had before, but it could point at one spot in the sky for about 80 days at a time, until sunlight would start leaking into the image. At which point, it could rotate and stare at a different spot for another 80-ish day campaign. This crazy plan worked, and the new mission was dubbed K2 and went into action. The K2 mission has discovered 323 confirmed exoplanets, and there's still a lot of data to dig through, so more could be confirmed years from now. K2 has even had some unexpected benefits. By looking at a variety of different stars, many of them in early stages of their lives, Kepler's observations have actually led to discoveries and insights into how stars and young planets form. After 5 years of the K2 mission, Kepler is running out of fuel, meaning that soon it won't be able to point itself back toward Earth to transmit scientific data. While NASA originally estimated it would only have enough fuel for 10 campaigns, the little spacecraft that could actually completed 18. It makes me want to light a candle for it or something. Its successor, the Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite, or TESS, was launched in April of 2018 and will search almost the entire night sky for exoplanets. But if exciting news ever comes out about a planet and it's got Kepler in its name, now you'll know the story of the amazing spacecraft that discovered it. If you like this video, take a second and subscribe. Kepler isn't the only space telescope whose time is running out. Hubble's space telescope will be put out of commission soon too. For a fond farewell to this stargazer, check out Athena's video here. One cool thing about the Kepler mission is it was operated by undergrad students as young as 20, which I guess is the next best thing to being a self-made billionaire. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time on Seeker.